now, rookie! Find him! Just getting warmed up over here.
Let me have this one. Yeah.
Hi.
Better buy my big guns now, because you bet your ass your enemies will.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Oh, goody. Let's make mischief.
Looking for Diamond City? Just follow the signs.
you can't open the gate. Stop playing around, Danny. I'm standing out in the open here for crying out loud.
I got orders not to let you in, Miss Piper. I'm sorry. I'm just doing my job.
Ooh, just doing your job. Protecting Diamond City means keeping me out, is that it? Oh, look, it's the scary reporter.
I'm sorry, but Mayor McDonough's really steamed, Piper. Saying that article you wrote was all lies. The whole city's in a tizzy.
You open this gate right now, Danny Sullivan. I live here. You can't just lock me out. I know you're listening, Danny. Open the gate. You. You want into Diamond City, right?
I just got here, but yeah.
Shh. Lay along. What's that? You said you're a trader up from Quincy? You have enough supplies to keep the general store stocked for a whole month? You hear that, Danny? You gonna open the gate and let us in, or are you gonna be the one talking to crazy Myrna about losing out on all the supply?
Jeez, all right. No need to make it personal, Piper. Give me a minute.
Better head inside quick before old Danny catches on to the bluff.
This place, Diamond City. What is it?
Oh, the Green Jewel? She's a sight. Everyone who's anyone in the Commonwealth is from here, settled here, got kicked out of here. A big wall, some power, working plumbing, schools, and some security goons are what make Diamond City the big monster it is. Oh, love it or hate it. You'll see for yourself soon enough. Let's go.
Piper, who let you back inside? I told Sullivan to keep that gate shut. You devious, rabble-rousing slanderer. The level of dishonesty in that paper of yours. I'll have that printer scrap for parts.
That statement, Mr. McDonough. Tyrant mayor shuts down the press. Why don't we ask the newcomer? You support the news? Because the mayor's threatened to throw free speech in the dumpster.
Always believed in freedom of the press.
Oh, I didn't mean to bring you into this argument, miss. No. You look like Diamond City material. Welcome to the great Green Jewel of the Commonwealth. Safe, happy, a fine place to come. Spend your money, settle down. Don't let this muckraker here tell you otherwise, all right?
What are you two arguing about anyway?
What do you think? Print lies and everybody's happy, but if you print the truth...
Now, was there anything particular you came to our city for?
I'm trying to find someone.
Trying to find someone? Who?
My baby boy, Sean. He's less than a year old.
Wait, your son's missing? You hear that, McDonough? Is Diamond City Security just gonna stand by while a mother searches for her infant son all on her own?
No, don't listen to her. Well, I'm afraid that our security team can't follow every case that comes through. I'm confident that you can find help here. Diamond City has every conceivable service known to man. One of our great citizens can surely find the time to help you.
A mayor of a great city must know everyone. Who can help me?
Well, there is one private citizen, Nick Valentine, a detective of sorts who specializes in tracking people down, usually for debts or whatnot. Now, I have to get going. I'm sorry, Diamond City Security doesn't have time to help, but I'm sure Mr. Valentine charges a reasonable fee.
This is ridiculous. Diamond City Security can't spare one officer to help. I want the truth, McDonough. What's the real reason security never investigates anything?
I've had enough of this, Piper. From now on, consider you and that little sister of yours on notice.
Yeah, keep talking, McDonough. That's all you're good for. I'm impressed. Not everyone can claw information out of McDonough's tight-fisted hands. Why don't you stop by my office after you see Valentine? I think I just found my next story. Kiddo, how are the paper sales?
Well, the presses are getting overloaded. That motor is going to go soon if we don't replace it.
You've been saying that for weeks and the old girl still keeps cranking. Stop worrying so much. I gotta head into the office. You start whistling if you see any angry politicians coming our way.
Why? Is something wrong? Piper? Newcomers, as the Institute grabs you in the night, at least we warned you.
The Institute?
You ain't heard of the Institute, lady? They snatch people up in the night and no one hears from them again. It's all in the paper. Better eat up before they grab you, too.
Who's gone missing?
Drifters, residents, stadium seat snobs. Seems every year or so, someone's gone. And we all know why. So you better be careful, newcomer. The Institute is out there, and they'll grab you too. Like I said, it's all in the paper.
I believe you. Thanks.
You're a real lost lamb in the wolf's den, lady.
Calling me that?
Because of the blue jumpsuit you're wearing? You're a vault dweller. So here's the deal. I want an interview. Your life story in print. I think it's time Diamond City had a little outside perspective on the Commonwealth. You do that, and I'll tell you what. I'll come with you. Watch your back while you get used to the world above ground.
What kind of interview is this gonna be?
You are, get your opinion on life out there, and maybe load up a few tough questions and keep it interesting. What do you say?
All right, Piper. I'm in.
Good. Let's get down to business. So, I know you're from a vault. How would you describe your time on the inside?
My family and I were frozen. I didn't spend much time in the vault.
Wait, what? They boxed you up in a fridge? The whole time? Are you saying you were alive before the war?
Yes. I'm over 200 years old.
Oh my god. The woman out of time. So, you've seen the Commonwealth, Diamond City. How does it compare to your old life?
Honestly, seeing everyone surviving out here, rebuilding the world, it gives me hope.
That's surprisingly inspired, Blue. We're definitely quoting that. Now, I already know you're looking for your son, Sean. Do you suspect the Institute was involved in his kidnapping?
the Institute. Who are they?
That blue is the biggest mystery in the Commonwealth. No one really knows who or where they are, but their handiwork is all over. Synths. Synthetic people. Sent from their hidden labs to do the Institute's dirty work. Sometimes they even replace a person with a synth double. A little covert agent no one would ever suspect. Now, not everything that goes wrong has the Institute behind it, but there's always a chance. That's why I'm asking.
They make synthetic people?
That's right. There are two major kinds you have to watch out for. The first is an obvious fake. Skin looks like plastic, skeleton might even be showing. You see groups of them scouring the Commonwealth, killing people and scavenging what's left. I reported on University Point a while back. Whole town got cleaned out. The second type of synth is the real deal. With skin, blood, warm smiles and guilty glances, just like a good old-fashioned human. So do you think they could be involved? The Institute or one of their agents?
Sure sounds like they might be.
Not even a baby is safe from them. And people wonder why I can't just look the other way. For the last part of our interview, I'd like to do something different. I want you to make a statement to Diamond City directly. The threat of kidnapping is all but ignored in the Commonwealth. Everyone wants to pretend it just doesn't happen. What would you say to someone out there who's lost a loved one but might be too scared or too numb to the world to look for them?
Wait, people just ignore kidnappings out here?
Yeah, Blue, you haven't noticed? You grow up in the Commonwealth and eventually someone is gonna get taken. Maybe not someone you know, but someone. And people just say, well, could have been worse. Could have been killed by raider attacks or super mutants or feral ghouls. They just give up. So I want my readers to hear what keeps you going. Maybe they'll find a little inspiration. Now, what would you like to say?
No matter how much you want to give up, don't. You have to have hope that you'll see them again, or at least that you'll know the truth.
A strong note to end on, Blue. Thanks. That's everything. It's gonna take some time to put this all together, but I think your story is gonna give Diamond City plenty to talk about. Anyway, I agreed to come with you, right? Watch your back? Just say the word when you're ready. I can't wait to see where the story goes next.
Piper.
Head my way?
Sure, let's go.
Will do. Big, loud,
it's the secretary of his, her and her perfect hair.
Mm-hmm.
It's a pleasure to serve you. Secretary, come on. I cut her hair myself, and I know human hair.
That's just it, Johnny. You wouldn't be able to tell the difference. If you nicked McDonough with your razor, he'd bleed. Don't mean nothing.
Do yourself a favor and just say yes. It's all he understands. Yes?
She told me everything. Whoever lies, gone. I mean,
Why buy
Something
just an ordinary
one.
Piece of
Does
wood?
Anyone fight back?
A swatter
Institute
is a custom-made piece of
what?
Genuine.
You mean the railroad? That's a fairy tale, man. They don't exist.
Yeah, I heard from my cousin. He knows a guy that works for him. They got a code phrase and everything. Follow the Freedom Trail.
The hell is that supposed to mean? You're full of it. That kind of talk is gonna get you smashed up by the synths.
Protection for sale! Hand-tooled pieces!
What's with you vault dwellers in those jumpsuits, huh?
We buy and sell
everything
to everyone.
Tell
except
me,
synths.
Are you
no synths allowed
the
here.
Infiltration of Diamond City's only
way to synths? Yeah, Piper, I am. I ain't buying your lousy newspaper.
Oh, well, thanks.
Told you your luck wouldn't last forever. His ties. Oh, Nick.
Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
Wait, who are you? You the detective?
Me? No, I'm Nick's secretary. Handle his appointments, his papers, that sort of thing. Well, that's what I used to do anyway, but now Nick's disappeared and I can't keep a detective agency open without a detective.
Nicky's missing. What has he gotten himself into this time?
Do you have any idea how I could find him?
He disappeared working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
Who's this Skinny Malone character?
I don't know much about him, but he's from Good Neighbor, and that means he's in the well-pressed suits and machine gun school of thuggery.
You said Malone's from Good Neighbor?
Yeah, it's a tough neighborhood. Northeast a ways. People with power there care about two things. Style and body count.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
Perfect.
Well, take your time. The literate keep me fed.
Don't move, Synth. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a Synth. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family!
Put the gun down, now!
He's a Synth! He'll kill us all!
Kyle, no!
Okay, Show's over. There are no synths in Diamond City. Hear me? Just you folks and your damn paranoia.
Still say Malone's weak. Caught that detective snooping around him. What does he do? Locks him up. Like he ain't got the balls to just kill him.
Well, don't let his new girl hear that. She'll start swinging that bat of hers in your face until there ain't no face left.
What?
Say hello to
you
on! Let me carry something before you cripple yourself.
So I got a question. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. We used to pull this kind of gun all the time back before the war. Get a bunch of union boys to work some construction job that would go nowhere. Keep everyone on payroll.
How you doing in there, Valentine?
Feeling hungry? Want a snack?
Keep talking, meathead. It'll give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really? I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words. Then he struck the name across three times.
Three strikes? In the black book? But I never... Oh, no. I gotta smooth this over fast.
What the... Time to put...
Expected? Sweet.
Hey, you! I don't know who you are, but we got 3 minutes before they realize muscles for brains ain't coming back. Get this door open!
Just going to waste otherwise.
You gotta hack that terminal to open up this door.
Gotta love the irony of the reverse damsel in distress scenario. Question is, why did our heroine risk life and limb for an old private eye?
I need you to find someone, but it's... it's complicated. I don't exactly know where they could be or how long they've been gone.
Well, I've done jobs with less. Somehow nice and simple never makes it onto the menu in my world. Been cooped up in here for weeks. Turns out the runaway daughter I came here to find wasn't kidnapped. She's Skinny Malone's new flame. And she's got a mean streak. Anyway, you got troubles, and I'm glad to help. But now ain't the time. Let's blow this joint. Then we'll talk.
Excellent.
Malone's crew here used to be small time. Muscled out of the old neighborhood by bigger players. So they found this place. Don't know what happened to the previous owners, but they're not exactly around to charge rent. Empty vault. Perfect hideout.
Hold on. I hear some of them coming. There they are. How do you want to play this?
My job is to check on the prisoner. Why does that take so fucking long? Dino, quit razzing that detective and get down here! I'll find you.
Something up.
Door's on the fritz. Let me see if I can get it open. Almost got it. There we are. Hell of a lot easier to do when the lock isn't on the other side.
Break a sweat.
Not that it's an option.
Bingo.
How much of this do you think still works?
They got the drop on us!
Time to put you on ice!
Skinny Malone and the rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's, ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door.
Okay.
Step through this door, get ready for anything.
Shoot up my guys? You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, poor little Valentine. Ashamed you got beat up by a girl. I'll just run back home to Daddy, shall I?
Should've left it alone, Nikki. This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should have just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Darla, I'm handling this! Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this lady doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought her here to rub us all out.
What's the deal with you people and Nick anyway?
Darla's a runaway. Her father wanted me to bring her back home. Turns out she skipped town to be with my old pal Skinny Malone, mob boss. Never thought he'd manage to scrape together a big enough crew to take over a vault. Guess life's full of surprises.
Hey, who's running this show here? You got something to say? Say it to me.
You and Nick know each other?
It's troublemaker here used to be a real headache back in the day. Before we got kicked out of the old neighborhood. Must have done this dance 100 times. Enemies are kind of the closest thing you get to friends in these parts. Now quit stalling. You're gonna talk? Talk.
This is all just a misunderstanding, Skinny. You know that. You let us walk, and we won't come back.
Like hell you won't! Don't you get it? All the other crews in the area will see this as weakness. Then they'll come for me!
Sorry. Time to give you both the hard goodbye.
Awkward conversation with Darla's parents when I tell them their daughter bit the big one. Well, at least the case is closed. Let's get out of here. There's a service ladder that should take us right to the surface. Commonwealth sky. Never thought anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me, anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about a missing person. No trace of where they've gone. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
I'll meet you there.
See you in Diamond City.